Hello everyone, what's up and welcome back to another video. Thank you for clicking on my face. Now, on June 22nd of 1954, Juliet Holm, I pray that I'm saying her name right, Juliet Holm and Pauline Riper, but technically Pauline Parker, killed Pauline's mom. I wish I was joking. Now, it was a beautiful day in Christchurch, New Zealand, when Pauline and her good friend, you know, Juliet, decided to kill her fucking mom. Now, there's a lot of stuff that went into this, so the video might be a little long, but please bear with me. Okay, well, first, a little bit of a backstory. Both Pauline and Juliet were what we consider to be antisocial. They really didn't like to get along with anyone. They had really snobby attitude towards anyone as well that tried to speak to them. And they had various things in common. They had a really sick, they had illnesses in the past that brought them to near-death experiences. They also had a very great, you know, appreciation for literature, the arts, you know, you name it, they pretty much had an appreciation for it. They also spent a great deal of time in their imagination. Now, this is where it gets a little bit funky. Now, at school, they attended a girls' high where when they met, they right away kicked it off. Now, this is mostly because since they had illnesses in the past that brought them to near-death experiences, they couldn't really participate in any activities. Like, they couldn't run, they couldn't do the hardcore stuff because Juliet had, you know, she suffered from bronchitis, so she had a weak chest. And then Pauline, well, let's just say the girl, like, was left with a fucking limp. Like, she... Long story. Anyway, so with plenty of things to bond over and them not spending any, you know, any... With them not participating in any activities, you know, they quickly spent a lot of time in their head. And ironically, they wrote poetry. Some of that poetry is rather creepy. If you read it, I believe you can find it if you really try and search for it. And they also wrote stories that were crime-oriented, like, they were about crime and shit. I really can't pronounce the word for some reason, so I'm not gonna try. But anyway, they spent a lot of time writing about, you know, killers, making up their own little characters and saying, oh, so-and-so killed that one. And they even made up their own religion with, you know, their saints, gods, and all that type of shit. They even went so far as to kind of say, well, wonder how all of these saints would be in bed. I know it's rather creepy, but Pauline does state it in her diary. Yes, she kept a diary and kept a lot of detail in there, and so did Juliet. Now, one of the things that does amaze people is that Juliet came from a very, like, we would, like, what would be said, high class, like, rich. Pauline, not so much. And the only way these girls actually met was in girls' high. That's the only way they could have ever met each other. Because either that, they even stayed at different parts of the town. So other than that, there was no possible way of them ever meeting. But anyway, fast forward a little bit and you have Juliet's mom, Hilda, had an affair with a guy named Bill Perry. Now, it was okay, they had a fling. However, you know, at this time, Pauline and Juliet had, like, basically a fantasy to run away to Hollywood so they can become actresses and publish, I mean, not publish, like, direct movies on what they write and all that stuff. So, they plan to use this information to blackmail. However, instead of blackmailing, Hilda, frankly, came out to her husband, Henry, and later on, they sat down Juliet and said, basically, we're getting a divorce. Now, it wasn't enough to tell her that they were getting a divorce, but how, since they saw that her relationship with Pauline was progressing, like, really obsessively, like, they were together, spending all times in their heads. Pauline slept over her house and, like, basically spent, like, a week there straight. Even gave her, like, a guest room and an assigned bed. But Pauline would put a dummy in a bed and then spend it in Juliet's room. And I know how it sounds, like, I really do. Anyway, with telling Juliet that she would be sent off to South Africa, they really saw no other way. So, the only one who they saw that was getting in their way of finally, staying together, not separating, was Pauline's mom. Unfortunately, they never really bonded at all from what anything lets me know. They had just short instances where Pauline would try to be nice, but that was because her mom would give her certain conditions to where she had to be nice in order to get certain things. Anyway, this is also known in her diary. I mean, why the fuck did she keep a damn diary in the first place? Anyway, Pauline specifically laid out their plans to the murder, and on the actual day of the murder, she called it a happy day. Not those exact words, but yeah, the happy day. That's what they all know it to be, the happy day, as June 22nd of 1954. They went out for a stroll. They went to a tea kiosk, which I never knew they fucking had until, I fucking looked into this and shit, until I read about it. And then they went for a stroll. Now, Pauline had been there before, which is how she knew that stroll was kind of dangerous, kind of like isolated, so it was perfect from what their plan was. Juliet also said that she would drop a pink stone. She would drop it and then tell, Pauline's mom, like, hey, look what I found, so to get her distracted. So what they did, swear to God, these are dumb bitches. I mean, they thought they were really smart and that they can get away with it and, like, run off together and never get caught for some fucking reason. I don't know. But they put a half brick in a stocking, and with that, they used it to smash Pauline's mom's head. Now, I don't like that. I really don't. She tried to get up. She tried. But they actually saw markings of little fingers that were pressed up against her so hard that they made bruises. So it was obvious that they tried to hold her down. Now, here's where it gets graphic. And unfortunately, I don't get monetized and I'm never going to get monetized, so I don't really give a fuck. She was trying to defend herself, so her pinky was basically, not there. It was only hanging by a few pieces of skin, in which it's disgusting. And, again, they're really fucking stupid, because they decided to run, crying, in a state of shock, and saying that Pauline's mom fell, hurt her head various times on a fucking rocks. And then later on, Pauline changed it a little bit, saying, I think I saw a brick. So she changed it, that she had a spasm, basically hit her head multiple times on a brick. They tried to lift her up, but when trying, they accidentally dropped her and she hit her head again. So that's when they ran, because they thought that they hurt her. Now, obviously, this was bullshit, because when right away they interviewed these girls and they both gave the exact same version of the story. However, Hilda told her, hey, they're looking into this as a murder. So Juliet decided, like any other fucking person, pointed the finger at Pauline and said it was all her idea. I wasn't even there. They were arguing and I didn't want to be there because they never argued in front of me. So I left ahead of time. Basically stating it was all Pauline. She had nothing to do with it whatsoever. And okay, they went to Pauline. So like, so we got a different version of the story. Juliet basically says it's you. And Pauline basically agreed. She changed her story completely and leaving out the fact that Juliet was even present. However, after all this was said, they did arrest Juliet. They took her to a holding cell, what we call now is a holding cell. But anyway, they took her there where she wrote on a piece of paper, yada, 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 I took the blame for everything. So obviously the cops, felt like if they were being made a fool out of, and they went and they arrested Juliet, who actually they got enough evidence considering that they asked, Pauline's father if she had ever written diaries, considering that she wrote on this piece of paper. He said, yeah, turn in every single one of her diaries, and right there he found extensive plans plus more, in, like, basically indicating how long they've been planning this, how extensive their plans have gone, even with relationships with them bathing together in the bathtub. No comment. Now, obviously, the police did go to Juliet in order to arrest her. However, before that, Hilda did go through Juliet's diaries and saw that, you know, to anyone with a fucking brain reading it, she'd be found guilty of all counts, considering that they planned extensively and everything. So she made her husband, Henry, burn it for reasons that she herself was like, oh, we were going to buy her new ones. Since we were moving, we wanted to get all the old stuff out, and we decided to burn her old diaries. Now, she was known to be a liar, so, you know. But, you know, they still arrested her. They found complete evidence that they both did it. And during this whole entire time, even during the trial, their only concern was that they not be separated. And considering that they were minors, but well, way back then, it was immediate death if you murder anyone and were found guilty, immediate death sentence. However, since they were minors, they couldn't receive the death penalty and were given extensive prison time. But however, this prison time was only 5 years since they were released early. Now, later on, they did interview Juliet in person, you know, as she is now. She now is 80 years old, and they asked her if one of her early releases, like their early releases, were because they agreed to never contact each other ever again. She denied this claim, saying no, they were never, they, I mean, yeah. She denied these claims because, well, basically, that was never an option. They were on good behavior, is basically what she said. And she also stated the fact that they were never lesbian. Now, this is important because throughout the entire trial, that was brought up so many times because of Pauline's diary. Because of the fact that she mentioned that they spent hours together in bed just talking. She just said talking. I don't know how the fuck they got fucking from that. And they spent time in the bath. I can see how they got that from that. But she denied the lesbian rumors, allegations, and she denied the fact that she only got an early release because they agreed never to contact each other again. Now, you have to admit them being separated, because that was their punishment, their grand punishment, was that they be separated and sent to different prisons. They were, you know, less and less involved with each other. Of course, there wasn't that emotional, mental bond in order to keep them obsessed with one another. So I feel like they kind of lost interest. And, ergo, you know, Juliet, they both changed their names after, you know, being released from prison. Ironically, they moved to the same location. However, they have never contacted each other. Since Julia is now 80, where I'm pretty sure that Pauline is 81, considering that they were only a few months apart. Now, I also find this fucking important, because Juliet is now a famous crime novelist. Consider that irony enough. You can find her as Annie Perry. And Pauline, you can find her as Hillary Nathan. Now, Pauline doesn't wish to speak on, you know, what's going on. A reporter even tried to contact her, and she still said no. She still want nothing to do with it. However, they did interview her sister, Wendy. But, you know, if you want to read all that, I will put the links in the description down below, and you can read it. And also, guys, I super, super recommend a book that I have read, which is true inspiration for me to make this video and all the information that I could fit in my little fucking head, I managed to, you know, tell it to you guys. The book is called Annie Perry and the Murder of the Century. I really recommend it. It's kind of a long read. It basically goes extensively through the whole entire trial and through basically their whole time when they were incarcerated. So if you want to read that, if you want to go deep dive further into that, I really recommend that book. You can also get it on Amazon Kindle. So thank you all so much for watching and have a great fucking day. By the way, if you want me to talk about any subject in particular, feel free to put it down in the comment section down below. All right, guys, thank you all so much for watching and have a great fucking day.